Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Nova War.
And Maximus Black.
And this is part two of our best of three match against Mr. Blimp and Mr. Sybin. Last game, if you guys watched it, it's a bit long, so I will be very impressed and pleased if you did. We lost. And we didn't just lose a little bit, we lost all the way. We just basically got shut down entirely, but that's okay. Because now we are 100% for cereal that we're gonna win this match, and I don't even think I remember this match very well, but I do remember that I did absolutely nothing.
Yes. well, so yeah, it's the same thing. Actually, Blimp going with Zerg this time.
Which
last
I believe
game
is his main race.
Yeah, it is. It is. His, I think it is.
I'm about 90% sure.
Yeah, I'm almost certain it is his main race. And Sybin is just your, you know, Protoss. He likes Protoss.
Yep.
And Adam's Protoss, and I am Zerg. And the game plan was for him to do that push with the gas. And then me jump right into Mutalisk, and we'll see how that goes.
Yeah, this is, we saw that Blimp had switched to Zerg, and normally if we're up against, if it's a mirror match, we do like to go Muta for the sole reason that normally we know at least one of the two are not going to be prepared for such fast Muta in such great numbers. But other than that, again, just like last match, once that first push of resources is done, we like to just basically scout, sit down, and do exactly what we need to do. But again, in the openings, you're not going to see anything different. Jeff is going to do basically a very simple opening. I do a very simple opening. And the only real difference is I get a bit faster gas, and I think Jeff gets a little bit faster gas as well. And then there's a resource switch, and that's about it.
Yeah, it looks like Blimp actually did a fast expansion. This is very typical for Zerg, and I know this. And this is a reason why I told Adam I wanted to go Mutalisk. I think we were actually arguing for a quick second about me going Roach. But I didn't want to do it because I know that Zerg is very, very vulnerable against fast Mutalisk. Because, for one, usually, unless they go fast Muta, they're not going to be ready for it.
They usually get Roach.
They usually get Roach, exactly. They usually get Roach and or they usually get a fast expansion. So when you get the fast expansion, it's automatically going to slow you down, and the Roach obviously can't attack Muta. The only thing that he'll have in his base would be a queen. And or if you were to scout and see that there is a spire going, he'd be able to get a couple of spore crawlers. But in that case, I could just run up to his partner here and do some damage, and we are...
I don't know.
I have no idea.
I think that was you just saying, all right, something is happening down there. I have no idea what that was. But what I do know is, while we were blabbering on there, Blimp was getting amazing scouting information done. I couldn't get his stupid drone out of my base. He was up running around in there getting all sorts of good information. So he knows that I'm doing a very simple opening. I think when we were talking on Vent, he hinted to the fact that he might have known that we were giving Jeff a whole bunch of resources. So maybe when he saw that fast gas, he was thinking, okay, maybe it's going to happen again and I'm going to have to get ready for it. But in any case, he got basically 100% of the information he needed for me to know almost exactly what I'm doing.
Yes, they're doing a good job at scouting, and it looks like there's a probe in my base. I have no idea that it's there. And which is never a good thing, because you never know, a pylon could go up there, anything could go up there. Also, the drone still sitting over here in the corner so that he can run it up later to scout and see exactly where we're going. My lair is now up. Adam just fed me the gas, so now I have 700, almost 800 gas. Throwing down that spire real quick. I did pump out a couple of Zerglings just to get them on these towers to make sure that an attack isn't coming. And if it were, I'd be able to get a couple of units. Basically, at this point, I am doing the teching. And Adam knows this. So Adam isn't, you know, getting ready to attack. He is kind of choking up a little bit and letting me do my thing. And he's also building some pylons up here. I don't know if he's trying to be sneaky about something or I don't know what's going on. But see, the thing is when you're teching up, you got to let your partner know you're doing it. Because if you're doing two different things, you could be in a world of trouble. So now I see that there's a couple of lings coming out from Adam's probe there. So we're going to get ready for this Ling attack, and it's not a whole lot. I think it's more just to see what the hell we're up to. Spire is more than halfway finished, and as you can see, I do almost have 900 gas, and I will have about 900 minerals by the time this finishes. So that's 9 muta, bam.
Yeah, no, exactly. That's exactly why we do this build. And as you can see, very smart, only bring up one Zergling. And look at that pylon, just like Jeff was saying, pylon going down. And if we don't notice that soon, we could be in a world of trouble. And he sees the spire just going up, though. And as soon as he sees it, there's all of that muta coming. So he knows what's on the way, and he's going to want to prepare for that. And he's getting his queens built up for the inevitable defense. I will say I put my pylons up there because of scouting purposes. I could see if they're going on the backside of my base, and I could hide a couple of buildings up there. But as you can see now, there are the muta, and Sybin came down to see if he could get rid of some stuff with a couple of zealots, but it's not going to obviously do anything against these muta. And pretty soon, Jeff is going to move out and do as much damage to their economy as humanly possible.
Yep, at this point, it is a game of harassment, and at this point Adam is in the clear to do what he does, where he can build up, get some units, give me backup once the initial damage is done, and then kind of put a seal on the envelope. And here we go. I'm coming in here first and foremost, want to get rid of these queens, want to take minimal damage, running that muta out because keeping your units alive is important. Now I can do more damage with this mutalisk, even though he would have died there. And at the same time, keep building muta, bringing them over, doing some drone damage right now. A lot of players will make a mistake where they'll just start to attack a hatchery. No, we're going to go off here and we're going to go right up to the partner when he brings his units down and then go after their probes.
Hey, Jeff.
Yes, sir.
What am I doing right now? Absolutely nothing! I am sucking so much balls right now, you have no idea. I think there was a solid 2 minutes where my APM was zero. I was literally staring at the screen, drooling, because I wasn't doing anything at all. I was just like, oh, okay, cool, Jeff's over with Muta. Let's watch what he's doing. I have, like, next to no units. I've had all this time to build up a force to defend against an inevitable counterattack, and instead, look at my army coming down here. I want you to look at the pitiful-ass army I've got. Really? We are 10 minutes into the game, and I've got, what, 7, 8 Stalker? That's...
Yeah, not good. Not good. So Adam's just going to take the walk of shame there. And meanwhile, I'm over here doing some serious damage to the drone count, being relentless, keeping those muta coming, keeping them going. I now have... how much minerals do I have? I now have 1,700 minerals. Not doing a great job at building some backup lane or anything, but right now I want to use all my larva to build my muta. I should be expanding right now, but to be honest with you, I need to keep going back and forth, because Blimp is doing a great job at going from one end to another, to keep his drones out of harm's way for the most part, the best he can do, getting those queens. And
holy
it looks
crap,
like
I'm
Adam,
doing something.
It looks like Adam's actually coming up here. But it still looks like Purple still has more units than Adam does. And how much money does Adam have at this point?
No. Wow, I'm actually using my money.
Yeah, so I don't know what you're using it on. You might be donating it to me.
That's
at this point.
Yeah.
He could be feeding me more money so I can keep getting mutalisk. In the meantime, I have no idea where my mutas are. I might have lost them. Oh no, we still have some here doing some damage. So this is best case scenario for us right now. This basically keeps Purple in on his side, not attacking us, because he needs to help his partner defend. Now getting those evolution chambers, maybe going to try to get a couple of spore crawlers up right now, but I think the damage has been done. These Stalker are going to go down with relative ease, and now I have a bunch of Mutalisk, and it's basically nonstop harass to the win.
Hey, Jeff.
Yes?
What am I doing right now?
Getting
nothing again. I am doing absolutely nothing. I could have been out of this game. I could have just gone AFK for 13 minutes and had absolutely zero effect on this entire match. You know what I did? I built a 9 pylon real well in that match.
Well, you know what, Adam? You played a pretty important part. I mean, yeah, you kind of shit the bed.
you gave me
gas, and that's about it. But you know what? Whatever, right? We're winning this game right now. I'm going to let my expertise shine. And Adam coming in with another batch of units. Purple with low unit count at this point. And I think this is probably... And there we go.
Am I going to kill a building?
Throwing out the GG. Blimp GG.
Yes!
IGG. And I gladly give Adam a win.
I killed that hatchery.
Good for you. So that was game two. It is now 1-for-1. That was a little bit better of teamwork for the
you,
mineral.
Yourself and yourself?
For the mineral sharing. I was just starting to get a couple more hatcheries now to build more units, getting that expansion. A little too late, but whatever. You know, the win was in the bag, and all my my focus was going on harassing. So, you know what? That was a good game. We all played well. It's just the fact that they weren't ready for the Muta, and I'm telling you, you know, maybe me and Adam will come up with like some sort of in-depth tutorial on how to really. It's really not that hard to do.
I don't think it's that in-depth, but we can do.
But
one
we can do one if you guys want to. If you guys want to see us do a tutorial of some sort, just comment under teamwork when it comes to feeding each other money and giving each other control of units. But I'm gonna leave it at that. Good game. We won game two, so it's 1-1. The winner of next game is gonna take this small little practice series, and pretty excited to see what happens. So. This is Maximus Black.
This is Nova War, and I promise I will actually do something next game.
All right. Peace out.
Peace.